Good evening. This is Greg Katnick, along with the groomsmen. We are in Cocoa Village Community Civic Center, preparing for the wedding of Les Donow and Barbara Wilcox. This is located in Brevard County, state of Florida, planet Earth. And the couple, the happy couple, is getting ready to pursue their dreams, make their dreams come true, and we are here today to do everything we can to help with that.
Funny how I feel more myself with you than anybody else that I ever knew. I hear it in your voice, see it in your face. You've become the memory I can't erase. You could have been anyone at all, a stranger falling out of the blue. I'm so glad it was you.
I'm Nathan, and
my name is Earl, and we are here celebrating my mom and Les's wedding, and hopefully here we're going to have a nice wedding, and then we're going to move on to a nice reception and have a lot of fun today.
Mickey Mouse taking a bath with Minnie Mouse.
My dear Les, did you ever think that 8 years ago on our first date that we'd end up married? What a wonderful path we have walked since then. I learned how wonderful you are. It is so easy to love someone who treats you as the most precious thing on earth. I'm excited for our new adventure, starting with today, the first day of our life together, beginning with a ceremony blessed by family and friends we love, and ending the day doing exactly what we did when we first met, and on our very first day, dancing. You make my heart dance. I love you, Les.
Wasn't in the plan, not that I could see. Suddenly a miracle came to me. Safe within your arms, and I can say what's true. Nothing in the world I would keep from you. You could have been anyone at all. An old friend called. I'm so glad it was you.
Here we are at the Cocoa Civic Center getting ready for the wedding celebration of Barbara and Les. I'm Barbara's sister Susan. Behind me we have the other bridesmaids, ring bearers, stepmother and mother of the bride. Actually, I see the mother of the bride standing behind the videographer. And we're all very excited and getting ready to go.
You are a very special person. In many ways, you're above the ordinary. You go way out of the box when you put your mind to an idea. You have a goal, a plan of action, and definitely a purpose. You're caring, faithful, generous, loving, gentle, affectionate, and so many other great qualities. This is why I want to be with you forever and ever as husband and wife. You are my special flower. Like most relationships, there are peaks and valleys. Right now, I feel like I'm on top of Mount Everest. With you by my side, let's stay on this peak forever. I love you very much, Barbara. Your loving husband, Les.
Oh, that was a great letter. It did not make me cry. It made me smile.
Along with me, the best is yet to be. When our time has come, we will be as one. God bless our love. God bless our love.
Hi, Les. It's almost time, and I don't know about you, but I'm getting really nervous. And this is like, I'd say a dream come true, because like that's part of our fairy tale relationship and our fairy tale wedding. And you have really made my life complete. You have given me lots of love. I feel supported, which makes me do even more things and have you by my side. I know a lot of people always say that the wife is the better half, but you really make me better. And so I guess maybe you might be my better half, and that you are the better half, because I can't do this without you. And pretty soon we'll really be able to stay together forever. And how exciting, and ready for new adventures. And I can't wait to be with you. Love you.
Hi, sweetheart. It's me talking to you right before our wedding. And within a half hour, we'll be walking down the aisle. I'm looking forward to this so much. And as you know, I get very misty. So I'll try to say a few things. I love you very much. And I'm looking forward to our spending the rest of our days together and having fun. The way we've been doing for the last 8 years. And I want to say happy anniversary to you today, our eighth anniversary. It's been a whirlwind romance as far as I can see. And tonight we are throwing probably the biggest party we'll ever throw. And it's going to be beautiful, fun, magical, and all those good things. And I want to thank you for all your patience with me. It's been kind of a little hectic today. I just want to let you know I love you. Looking forward to walking down the aisle with you, holding hands, giving you a big kiss when the Reverend says time to kiss, and our first dance, walking around the room tonight, talking to people, and welcoming our friends, and we'll have a good time. The weather is ideal so far. We're very blessed about no rain so far. So I'm looking forward to seeing you in a little while, and spending a lot of time the next 2 weeks on our honeymoon together. I can't wait, as you well know. So at this time, I'm going to say we'll see you soon. And I can't wait to turn around when you walk down that aisle and I come and get you. I just can't wait. Love you, honey. See you soon. Bye.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to celebrate the marriage of Barbara Jean Bickford Wilcox and Lester Davis Donow.
They say it's a man's world, well, that cannot be denied. But what good's a man's world without a woman by his side? And so I will wait until that moment you decide. My girl, that I'm the sea and you're the pearl. It takes two, baby. It takes two.
Barbara, do you take Les to be your husband?
Do
you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding only unto him forevermore?
I do. I would do that.
Les, please hold Barbara's hands in your hands, palms up, so that you may see the gift of your hand.
Okay.
Barbara, these are the hands of your best friend. The hands that will always hold you gently and safely in the embrace of his love. Les, do you take Barbara to be your wife?
Yes, I do.
You promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only unto her forevermore.
I do.
Barbara, place your ring for Les on his left hand and repeat after me.
Is that the correct hand?
Les, you are my one true love and my best friend.
You are my one true love and my best friend.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a token of my love and devotion.
As a token of my love and devotion.
With my heart.
With my heart.
I pledge to you all that I am.
I pledge to you all that I am.
With this ring, I will marry you.
With this ring, I will marry you.
And join my life to yours.
And join my life to yours.
Les, is there a token of your love for Barbara?
Yes, there is. Thank you, Ella. Thank you.
Les, place your ring for Barbara on her left hand. Barbara, you are my one true love and my best friend.
Barbara, you are my one true love and my best friend.
I give you this ring as a token of my love.
I give you this ring, the token of my love.
Wear it with love and joy.
Wear it with love and joy.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
Neither will my love for you.
Neither will my love for you.
I choose you to be my wife.
I choose you to be my wife.
This day and forevermore.
This day and forevermore.
The storm when I am weak. You are the words when I can't. Never fail to see me through. That's the love I found in you.
Les, you may kiss your beautiful bride.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's with great honor that I present to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Lester and Barbara Donow.
To everyone here for the very first time anywhere as husband and wife, let's have a big warm welcome for the brand new Mr. and Mrs.
I am in awe of her talents and energies and accomplishments, and especially, as we can all experience today, her irrepressible sense of fun. I not only love you, but I admire you. So as you might guess, we have very high standards for anyone that we would consider a worthy partner of Barbara. Les, before we even met him, was okay with us, because one of the first things we knew about him was that he and Barbara went dancing together. And as you can tell, Barbara loves to dance, and anyone who takes Barbara dancing is a good guy in our book. And as we got to know Les better, we loved him for his wonderful, generous spirit and his easygoing nature and that lovely sense of fun that he shares with Barbara.
One day we were out at lunch and we came into the restaurant, sat down, and he had his arms on the table and he leans forward and he looks me right in the eye, and there was just silence for a few seconds, and he says, "I met somebody last night." "I went dancing at the Moose Lodge and I met somebody. Her name is Barbara."
And so I really got to know this couple in the world of dancing, but I also got to know them in the world of Disney. And when I really started to think about it, I realized that this couple, with the way they live their lives, could be the inspiration for Disney fairy tales and movies. And so he said, "Would you like to dance?" And she said, "Yes, but I'm not a very good dancer." And he said, "Well, I'm learning myself. Let's do it together. Let's work on it together." And from that point on, they danced into each other's hearts. Walt Disney once said, "To love would be an awfully big adventure." Today, you saw this couple continue their big adventure. They are working to make their dreams come true. So if you'll raise your glasses and gather with me in a toast, may all of your days be happy and filled with dancing. May you continue your adventure, and most of all, may you live happily ever after.
What a fabulous day this has been. It started early this morning, but that's beside the point. But the ceremony was so beautiful. And Greg, who was standing over here, was telling me, make sure you don't look over there. Make sure you look at me at a certain point. And I was watching Greg. And then Greg was almost counting down. She's at the fifth chair, and she's coming down, ready, 1, 2, 3. Well, when I turned around and saw you, you who never wears makeup and never wears your hair differently, I was overwhelmed. I mean, I was overjoyed, overwhelmed, taken aback, or whatever. You look so, beautiful, beautiful, a princess.
Well, that was the idea.
Well, the whole idea.
I was telling Susie, I said, I think he's waited 8 years for me to finally put on makeup, but I hope he doesn't expect it every day.
you were beautiful, honey. And when I took your hand,
When I was shaking?
I started shaking.
Because I was shaking.
Oh, yes, I know.
I don't know why. Yeah. Though.
Well, because you were...
overwhelmed. Not overwhelmed, I'm just emotional. It was just like seeing all these people that came and seeing you standing up here looking so handsome in your beautiful new jacket and your suit and your groomsmen and my bridesmaid sitting there watching us and oh my God, with my out of all the people I thought would not cry, I did not think my mom would cry. I was like, oh, it was just so touching.
I had tears in my eyes even when Linda started a little
teary with Linda. Yeah, but I mean, oh my God, it was just so special with my mom.
Well, you held up.
Well, it helped to, you know, look in your eyes all the time. So it was really nice that we could look at each other during the whole ceremony instead of, you know, having to look at a preacher or anything.
Yes, it worked out. It worked out great.
Really good. And you held my hand almost the whole entire ceremony.
Shaking too.
I wasn't shaking the whole time. I calmed down after. Actually, that's probably what calmed me down was, you know, holding your hand and you know, like it always says when I get hyper and you know, wild.
But it was really
you keep me grounded.
The ceremony went beautifully, and when we started to come in into the ballroom, and our first dance, since we hadn't practiced in about 3 days or 4 days,
with your dress, danced with this dress before.
Right, but it went great.
I got lots and lots of compliments. Everybody saying how much fun they had everything.
Oh yeah,
Barry
and his wife Debbie. He was overjoyed. I mean, Les. I mean, you know, he's gone to weddings before, but it was so beautiful.
Yeah.
A lot of people were very happy for us.
Well, we had a lot of good friends, and a lot of good family here. We're lucky. We love a lot of people, and they love us.
Right.
And what more could you ask for?
Right.
I love you, Henry.
I love you too, sweetheart.
Let's go play with fire.
Okay.
They sat on the swing, not saying a thing. They just looked.